showing you how to improve access to your digital world.
All right, I'm going to show you how to make a change in the voice for JAWS. I have it here on the task tray, and I'm going to click on it.
JAWS Professional.
I'm going to come up here to Options.
JAWS Context Menu Option.
Click Voices. Then voice click adjustment. Voice not, Adjustment. Not,
leaving menus.
It's currently set at Eloquence. This is the most common voice that you'll hear with JAWS. But JAWS can use other voices, and I'm going to now change it and show you some of those voices. So I'm going to change Eloquence.
Eloquence.
To SAPI 5.
Profile name colon combo.
And it gives me three choices.
Microsoft Anna. US Avid-Vocalizer. US Tom-Vocalizer.
So let's hear Tom.
Voice person colon combo box. Us Tom dash.
Voice person colon combo box. Us Ava dash vocal.
That's US Ava. And the one I like most is the Microsoft Anna. So I'm going to change it to that.
Us Ava.
Voice person colon combo.
Another thing that you can change is the speed by which it reads. If you bring it up this direction, this slider, you can make the voice read faster. And if you want it slower, you can drag it to the left. And you can also change how much punctuation is read. I'm going to leave all the settings as it is and click Apply.
Apply button to activate.
Click Yes.
Voice adjustment dial.
And then click OK.
JAWS Professional.
Navigating the System 7 operating system with JAWS. You might wonder how someone navigates around on the desktop using JAWS. The first primary point of interest is having a navigation point, and that is going to be the Start button down in the bottom left corner right here. Now, the way they're going to get to it is they're going to press either Escape and Control,
Control Escape
together,
menu. Search box Escape,
or
leaving menu.
They're going to press the key between the Control and Alt key on the left side of the spacebar.
Menu, search box Edit.
So once they get to the search box here, they're then able to navigate with complete assurance that they know where they're at. So let's say they need to start up one of the applications that's listed on the taskbar down here. They're just going to press escape. Then they're going to press tab.
Tab. Taskbar Windows Explorer.
So it went to Windows Explorer, which would allow them to go through their files. And then they can press tab again, and it'll go to the system tray.
Tab. System
which
tray
is
command tab endpoint protection
over
button.
Here.
To move between the buttons, use the left and right arrows.
If I press the arrow keys, I can move through those.
System tray command sky for business desk. New quick note button, creative cloud button, Bluetooth devices, Cisco AnyConnect secure mobility client V.
So I want to get to the desktop where the icons are. I'm going to press tab one more time.
Tab, show desktop button. To activate, press spacebar. Space, desktop, folder view, list view.
Now, if I want to open up a document from the sample docs folder, I'm going to press either the letter S for sample, or I'm going to navigate using arrow keys. The problem with JAWS is that it can't tell where the end of the line is very well. And so I'm just going to have to move around until I find it.
Outlook 2016. Acrobat Reader DC. Recycle bin.
Notice there's no order.
Word 2016. Sample docs.
So this is not a primary way that someone who is blind is going to use their computer. They're not usually going to put a folder on their desktop. What they would rather do is they would rather come to the Explorer down here and use that, Windows Explorer. But in this case, since I got to the file, I'm going to open it.
Enter sample docs.
And there you have
select list box.
A window that they can find their document in. Now, if you get caught, like I am right now, there is a keystroke that will help you to navigate again. Rather than having to press Escape and Control or the Windows button, I'm going to press the Insert key on the numerical keypad, and I'm going to press F10.
Leaving menus. Window list dialog.
So these are all the windows that are currently open. Most of them are minimized. And so I want to go back to the window, which is the sample docs.
2017 Camtasia on Camtasia, not JAWS Professional Recording DAW dot sample docs restored. Enter sample docs. Items viewed multi-select list box. Name split button.
I'm going to close this window, and that is a basic understanding of how to navigate using JAWS. There is one more thing I want to show you, and that is coming up.
Basics of
when I press the start menu button and this window pops up, I can type in the name of a program or the first couple letters of it, and it's going to show up on the list.
W-O-R-D.
So in this case, there are two programs that start with Word, Word 2016 and WordPad. And so I have to listen by pressing up and down arrow.
WordPad. Word 2016 left parent to right parent.
So when I want to open Word 2016, I just press Enter.
Enter. Leaving menus. Opening dash Word.
Again, to close out any window, you can press the Alt key and F4.
Alt F for.
And I'm going to go back to the window again by pressing the Start key.
Menu. Search box edit.
So that
type
is one way.
Type text in this edit field or press up or down arrow to.
The other way is to press the arrow keys.
All programs submenu. 8.
I can come to the All Programs and press Enter and then go through the list, or I can go through
read
this
and right, left,
start
XPS, view, paint, submenu
bar here and find something I'm interested in using.
Camtasia, getting started submenu. Connect to a prod. JAWS 17.0, remote desk, sticky notes. 8 of 11.
So this
enter
is sticky notes.
Leaving menus. Sticky note.
Now I'm going to move that over
type
in the
in
center here so you can see it better.
Edit. Type in text. T H I S space I S space A space N O T E.
You notice that JAWS reads each letter as I type it. Some people don't like to hear that.
Period. Space. Space.
They like to hear one word at a time. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to the numerical keypad and hold down the insert key and press number 2 above the Q and W.
Word.
Now when I type, it's going to read words.
This is another test. Space.
If I press it again, insert 2.
Both characters and words.
It will read the letters as I type them.
T-H-I-S. This. I-S. Is. T-H-E. The. L-A-S-T. Last. T-E-S-T. Test. Period.
Now, what you will find when you're training people who are working with JAWS is that if they type fast, they will want to turn off both words and characters. And so you press insert 2 again.
None.
And it will say none. And that allows a fast typist to type all their letters on the screen, all their words, without having to listen to it. But for someone who's just new to typing or someone who's a slow typist, they will have a preference between hearing each individual letter or each word being read to them. And that's basically how you type. Now, if you want to go back and read what you've written, you use the numerical keypad or the arrow keys on your keypad to move up through the document. So I'm going to go with 8 on the numerical keypad and go back up.
Another test. This is a note. This is.
I can also use the home key and then press down arrow, which is 2.
Another test. The last test. Another test. This is a note. This is.
Now, if I want to hear each individual letter, I'm going to press 6 and 4, moving right and left.
H I S space I S.
So that's 6, and then going back with 4.
I space S I H T.
Now if I want to have the word spelled to me, if I want to hear the individual letter that is in front of the cursor, I press 5.
T.
But if I want to hear the entire word, I press the insert key on the numerical keypad plus 5.
This.
Now, if I want to move through the document word by word, I can hold the control key down and press 6.
Is 8. Note. Period. This is another test. Period.
So that's your navigation and your typing within any kind of text box, any kind of field that you're typing in, any kind of word processor, in PowerPoint and in Excel. That's how you can navigate inside those forms to hear yourself and what you've written so that you can make sure everything is accurate.